Assalamu alaikum and welcome to The Entrepreneur. Once again, we're here with a very privileged guest. I'm Sharif Islam, by the way, your host. And today we have someone who is a dignitary in the community. He has been a very inspirational personnel in the community, benefiting a lot of youngsters who want to go into the business sector. I'm not going to say much because we got a lot to talk about. Today is an exclusive show because Sufi Bai is actually somebody who is quite hard to get hold of. I've also already mentioned the name, but let me just introduce you to him. He is a property tycoon, a business entrepreneur, a managing director of ATM Bangla UK. Welcome to the show, Mr. Sufi Mia.
Assalamu alaikum, Sharif Bhai. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for inviting
me for the show. And thank you to TV One as well for inviting me.
You're most welcome. Like I said, I mean, it's the pleasure's mine. And with a busy schedule, getting someone here is so I'm very, I appreciate it a lot.
Thank you. You have said a lot of things about it, but I'm not sure. But anyway, thank you again. And I've seen your show and it's fantastic.
Thank you very much. Everything that I've mentioned, I'm sure that you deserve more than that. But I'm not doing justice.
You're too kind.
However, like I said, welcome once again to the show. And today we'll be, obviously discussing how you became successful. And I know a bit about yourself, and I know, from a young age, you were someone who's always motivated with business, motivated with, putting your hands, whatever it is, making your hands dirty and making it work. So first of all, tell us a little bit about yourself, a little bit about the history of what the passion is behind business.
Sharif Bhai, thank you again. We all brought up in early, we all came to UK early 80s, and it was very tough for us, especially with the racism and living in Camden. It wasn't an easy place to live. Right. And nowadays, obviously, it's very easy and everything. I always wanted to be successful. My role model is Richard Branson. Oh. I always look at him and I always see he's wearing normal casual clothes. And he was such a big man and, And sometimes I used to read his book and everything, So.
And he's somebody who started from the bottom, didn't
bottom,
he?
Bottom, yeah, that's the end. And I always wanted to be success in the, not in the education way, but I shouldn't be saying that, but I always wanted to be a businessman. And to be a businessman, you have to be success and you have to do well in life.
Absolutely.
And, I thought, what is the best way to go move on fast? Because obviously I start in the retail business, went to Sao William College, we went to the same school.
We were
talking on the TV show. Okay. And, it basically start from like working in a, Camden Markets. I had a market stall for when I was 15. I had a Camden Market stall for about 2 years. But then again, I didn't work. I got my brother and my friends there to run it.
Right.
So I always have that kind of things. I always delegate other people.
Okay.
And I was trying to find the right people.
So you're more of a leader. When you say you've delegated other people, you're more of a leader. You had people who kind of followed you in things.
One good thing about me, when I do something good, I like to tell people. I've done this. Sometimes people think, oh, he's boasting. And actually, it's not about boasting.
Yeah.
It's sharing to your friends about your success. Sometimes it's a good thing. Because I know there's people in this world, they're not all nice people. But to me, then it's benefit to that person. And I always tell my friends, like when I start working my clothes business, that was the best thing that I closed half the Camden Market, £20 a day. I used to get, that was a lot of money, £20 a day. It was like £500 a week.
Yeah, I understand. Yeah. But if you appreciated that £20, that's the main thing.
But you have to appreciate it.
Upon it as something measly or anything like that. Yeah. So you appreciate it. And that's where you, now tell me about your school life. You mentioned something about in the school days, you did the work with Camden Town and stuff like that.
We both went to the same school.
We did, yes.
And I think we both probably were the same.
And let me just say, I'm honored to go to school, the same school as someone like yourself. For myself, I'm very proud. A friend of yours.
I think thank you very much, everybody. And it's a lot to me, like you're saying that.
Thank you.
When I went to Sao William College, obviously we went to early 80s. We came to this country.
School doesn't exist anymore.
No, school doesn't exist. But it was difficult. But and we had a family. Everyone's had a family. I think those days we had to support our family. And my dad used to work in the post office. My dad is not alive anymore. And I'm sure he's in a good place.
Yeah,
so
sure.
Basically, it's like. So that could be emotion.
No.
It basically was tough. So to support family. So I used to do paper round.
Okay.
My next door neighbor is, I used to work for Camden News Journal.
Wow.
400 like paper. Okay. Me and my older brother, Kobi Mia.
Yep.
Me and him used to go to do paper round every evening. Like, one of my friends got a job, so he gets 100.
How old were you then?
Oh my God, if I tell you how old these kids will be laughing at me now. I was about 11, 12.
Goodness. Fasterous. They're not going to be laughing at you. No, they should be inspired.
Like, my son is 14 years old. Okay. When he crossed the road, I go to him, Baba, be careful. Like, in 14 years,
hold
my hand, yeah? So those days was different anyway. Yeah. So I used to work in a Camden News Journal. Yeah. And then my next door neighbor, he got a job in, he used to go to every day paper. He used to get £7 a week. Okay. And I said, please find me a job there. So anyway, I still remember this person. He still rings me as well.
Wow.
Like Mukesh Patel, yeah?
Okay.
And he gave me the job for £7. Our Sunday used to be really hard because Sunday Times was so big papers.
Okay,
and
yes.
Sometimes my road is terrible. Like, we used to go two rounds, and my mom used to look in from the building.
I remember because I used to do the same thing. But I used to get a slightly more than more than you. But
so my mom used to look from the window. You know, those days was very racist and bike clear. So sometimes me and my brother used to look after each other.
Okay.
My friend, I'm like a group where they're
from tomorrow. You had each other's back.
Anyway, and then okay. I start working in Camden Markets. And yep. this is where I moved on to different things. Like, you know, one of my friends' brother called Nashir Bai, he used to buy and sell cards. So yeah. I saw he used to use our telephone number. Okay, loot paper takto.
Yes.
So I'm like, I'm tante kiami car.
You're bringing back all the memories,
yeah,
man.
So, and I, you know, the good thing about me, I remember every people. And I all appreciate right. about my past. I, you know, even now, alhamdulillah, I won't say I'm one of the, I can say like I'm done quite well.
Yeah.
But I still think of my olden days. And I think you need
to. So tell us, look, you mentioned a few things about the olden days. And obviously here, we're here to try and help or benefit the viewers who are watching, especially younger viewers.
Yeah.
And you are, you know, definitely an inspiration. Now, tell me, you know, when you used to do this, I mean, you said Richard Branson
yeah.
was somebody who motivated you.
That's
or,
right,
you know.
Yeah.
What was exactly, I mean, apart from that, what was your thinking? I'm going to do paper round. Am I going to save a bit of money? Am I going to go and buy some trainers or a pair of, what do you call it? In those days, chippy and stuff,
chippies,
Chevy
yeah,
and
yeah,
stuff like that, I remember.
Yeah.
Is that what your motivation was? Or
no.
was your thinking, you know, I'm going to get £7 and I'm going to actually save it because I want to do something bigger?
Okay.
You know, so just for the viewers.
You know, for the young age, I'm sure like you've got children, I've got kids.
Yep.
And if I look at my foot, I've got 4 kids, 2 boys, 2 girls. And when I look at them and I can tell, I hope I'm wrong, but I can say my younger boy,
yeah.
you know, I'm not worried about him because I know he's going to be like me.
Okay.
And the reason for that, because I'm such a tech unit, I'm a budget this whole time.
Would
so
you?
I never have, like basically have a dream
yeah.
to drive Ferrari when I'm not.
You
right?
never had a dream?
No, okay. I never had a dream. But now I have a dream to drive any kind of car because I'm
and you are.
Alhamdulillah, I can afford.
Yeah.
So I mean, always try it step by step.
Okay.
So I always tell people, fast crawl, then yeah. walk, then run.
Okay.
So don't try to be like, I it was also like, it's quite awkward for me. Like
yeah.
I'm sitting here and you're sitting there, you're
yeah.
asking me questions. And I do similar kind of show in my AT in Bangla.
Yeah, just
and
for the viewers, yeah. Sufi Bhai is actually, as I mentioned before, he is the managing director of AT in Bangla,
yeah.
Which is, a great achievement. Also, he has a show, I'm not going to mention the name of the show, but he has his own show. So today he is sitting on the other side. I mean, he's most welcome to come on this
yeah.
side and ask me questions, but it's not about me today, it's about him. So, you know, just to mention that in the, yeah. in the middle.
So basically, you know, I'm always trying to tell people,
yeah.
walk fast and then start thinking. So just because Richard Branson owns a music store and like Virgin Mega, shops
yeah, yeah,
and
yeah.
all the other
so
stuff.
So that inspired you?
It inspired me then as a normal man, inshallah, salon. I'm not a balafai. I'm not a balafai in a beshi johori, right? Anyway, so I started working clerks. One of my friends to work in a shoe shop.
Right, yes.
And those days, shoe shop was manchokito to me. Shoe shop was hamkorani. But few friends, yeah?
yeah?
But the problem was, like, basically, when I worked in the West End, there wasn't no Bengali people was working there. So I was only few people used to work in Top Men. I don't know if you remember, I don't know if they still exist or not.
Well, Top Men.
Top Men. Okay, anyway, yeah?
Top Shop.
Anyway, so there was a few Indian people used to work there because I used to go and buy my suit from there.
Okay.
Like, I'm not sure national like slot machine and Top Men.
Yes, I remember those days.
When I used to work in that, I used to feel very proud because I was the only one used to dress up really nicely.
Mm.
Now there's everything casual, ain't it?
Yeah.
Those days was different.
Yeah.
But I'm always been. I'm one of those guys, delegated guy. Even when I was
okay.
a salesman,
yeah.
And I always, if I believe something, I can sell it.
Right.
Like when I used to buy and sell cars,
yeah.
Right. I used to buy my cars from the auctions.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Yeah. I did fast. When I first bought my car, I didn't even know how to drive.
So let me just get this right. So afterwards, obviously you grew up, did paper rounds and stuff like that, and then slowly, obviously this is school time as well. You started working for Clarks when you were at school.
Well, after finishing my Friday Saturday job, I thought I need a proper job.
Yeah.
And we went to, I didn't want to go to further study, and I felt like I need to support my family, and that was the main reason.
Okay.
And at the same time, I.
So the thing is, the thinking behind it is also something quite important, and you said, I want to support my family.
That's right.
So already you've got that worry. Well, as a 15-year-old boy, now, shall I say?
16-year-old? I'm 16 years old.
Yeah, 16-year-old, you've got family in mind.
Yeah.
It's quite sad that nowadays, you know, children who are growing up at this age, they don't have family in mind. They have friends in mind and enjoyment in mind. But because of, what I just want to say is, your intentions were correct. So, you know, just for the viewers who are watching right now, you know, if family is in mind, then, you know, maybe Allah's blessed you in that. Family was in mind, and you went and got a job in Clarks.
Yeah.
Okay.
I tell you one thing about the blessing. And I've got four brothers. One brother died, and I have two other brothers now.
Okay.
But I always say I've got blessing from my mom and dad, because whenever I always looked after my dad. And I looked after him 16 years. Everyone looked after, but he was living with me 16 years.
MashaAllah.
So, you know, and I think Taradua Ase, because I believe that. And
definitely.
I believe if you look after your parents and viewers who's watching, they should be looking after their oldest. Yeah?
Oh, definitely. Okay. That's a part of
respecting
our
them. And we should be respecting our community, how they came up, this country, how they work. Because without them, we wouldn't be sitting here and
doing a
show in Bangla TV.
Absolutely.
So, you know, and...
Well, thank you for saying that, Sufi Bhai, because, you know, our parents are one of the most important parts, and they are a blessing to us. And as we know, parents are actually, I believe that they're part of your success.
Of course,
they're part of your success.
So, like, anyway, talking about 15 years old, like, if I talk about my son now, he's thinking tomorrow morning what boots he's going to buy, or what designing clothes he's going to buy. But those days, we had few friends. Yeah. They were like that, cheapy getting to slot machine.
Yes, yes.
I remember my brother and my brother's friend, as soon as they used to get their wages, they used to go and buy this label, because he's 17,
well, unfortunately, I was one of them as well.
Yeah. So he's spending money. But with me, I was spending money in my wisely.
Yeah.
And even now, I spend
but
my money
is,
in my wisely.
But the thing is, you stayed within your means, isn't
means,
it?
Yeah.
So same here. I used to do the same thing. But, you know, I never used to ask my father for money at that age. You know, I used to work and I used to get it. But going back to you again, you used to work for Clarks.
Yeah.
And how much of an achievement was that? Yeah. I mean, being in Clarks, you started maybe a salesman.
Yeah.
Tell me about Clarks, where you go.
I tell you one thing about something. You know, like, I'm the parents of Lamra Momrubi Khoinani, then Balaman Shalokatakle. If you hang around with good crowd, you be the good person. So I think I was hanging around with good crowd, I would say.
Okay.
Yeah? That's why, because I went to the right direction. Yeah.
Right.
So Clarks, obviously, I'm always a salesman.
Yeah.
And, I'm an honest salesman. And I know there's a tariff for right now.
No.
But
okay.
Being a good salesman, you have to be honest. Yeah.
Absolutely.
All right. And you have to be, you know, otherwise you're not selling me a con. Yeah.
You're
so
a con man. Yeah.
So
okay.
Anyway, so I stay in Clarks as a sales assistant. Mm. And then I thought, no, I can't keep running around. I need to be a, in the manager.
You need to go higher up in the ranks.
And those days when you become a good salesman, you can control your shop floor. You know, and turnover was like 10, 15 million on that time as well. It was
a Clarks.
big turnover was those days.
Oh, Clarks is the way.
So, you know, I become supervisor, then assistant manager, then branch manager. And on my first year branch manager, when I went there, obviously my salary was so high those days for me to go to smaller shop. They can't afford me.
Okay.
So they used to pay me London wages, and they told me don't tell anyone there to my Betun Beshi, which one, because they can't find me the right shop to give me
West End. Clarks,
yeah. So I became a manager, and even my first year, I got a manager of the year. I think I got about four-time manager of the year.
Okay.
Like, it's not about how much money you take. It's
so look,
how much
it's because of working hard. So you used to be an honest salesman.
Yeah,
you used to work for Clarks as a salesman, and then you moved up the ladder.
Yeah.
And they made you, was it a floor manager or the store manager?
Floor manager to store manager. Like
floor manager to store manager. Yeah, because I want to categorize it just for the benefit of the viewers, because it's all about learning here as well.
When I joined there, then they realize, my God, Asian people are hard working. You know, one thing about us, I'm proud to say, Bangladeshi people,
we're hard workers.
Not only Bangladeshi, but Asian people, I think It's hard working, yeah? Because we don't say, oh, I'm not sick, or you see, or you see. You know, how many people in the restaurants we say sick?
No, the hard workers.
Not even Johnny Fridays or anybody have been for the restaurant.
Very rare, limited staff.
So that's one benefit about, our Bangladeshi people.
So clerks appreciated that, the managers and the supervisors, they appreciate.
I'll tell you one thing about clerks. My manager, the manager I used to work in clerks under me, after 23 years, he communicated with me by social media.
Right.
He came to see me another day in my house.
Really?
Right. But he was driving up and down. He can't find my house. So I told him, it's the first time my wife actually met him as well. And
is that the new house that you
The new house. And he was passing in front of my house up and down. Do you know what he said? He said, Sufi, I'm so pleased for you. And you know, Shadaman is not jealous right now, but he said, I'm so pleased for you. Then you achieved that. Because here Facebook or not, like the link on Tamate. I was passing through about 5-6 times. He keep calling me and he keep saying you can't miss it. But I wasn't looking for that house. He was looking for normal house, even detached house, small, like, you know. But he was very proud. And I sometimes, sometimes you have to feel proud of yourself.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I have a lovely family. My wife support me all the time. You need that. You need your home support. Yeah. You know.
We're going to be talking about your family in a bit.
Yeah.
Going back to the rise of Sufimiya. Because I know a bit of your history. And I'm proud to say this, is when most of us were bunking off school, you used to say, you know what, I've got to go to work.
Yeah.
Do you understand? Yeah. So after that, or not bunking off school, because that's going to be a school time. Maybe school after, school,
after school,
we'll get together, we'll meet up, we'll hang around. And you used to say, no, I'm going to go to work. So, you know, this has actually have given you something big.
This is called sacrificing, yeah?
Yeah.
I tell you one thing, my friends.
Sacrificing.
Sacrificing. I tell you one of my friends, when I used to go to work, bus station, right? And basically, Tandalakto. So I see one day he come and pick my brother up with a BMW. Those days, BMW was a big thing.
Yeah.
With T-shirt Findo. So he said, Sufi, shall I drop you to bus stop or to the workplace? We're going that way. And he was wearing T-shirt, and I'm thinking, he has the Arame Boise, Arami, you know, suit Findo, Amar Tandalakto.
Sitting in a bus stop.
But thing is, you know, I used to have my fun, I used to have everything. It's not like I lost my fun.
You used to balance it.
I used to balance it, and you have to have a balance everything. Yeah. You
because
know?
We're not trying to tell anybody who are watching
you should
sacrifice, but it doesn't mean that you should miss out on the fun part of things. Because as youngsters, you know, part of your life is to have fun, halal fun, and do everything, be a part of the society, be a part of your peers, you know, get together and so forth. But at the same time, you know, work hard, study hard, and have an ambition. Have a dream, just like Sufi Bhai here has, and you know, you will reach somewhere. So not to miss out on anything, but be someone who will achieve something in life, not just someone who comes to this world and then goes and doesn't leave a legacy, let's say. So don't miss out on anything, but at the same time, have a dream. Am I right, Sufi Bhai?
Of course you're right. Yeah. But I think those days, early age, you have to grow up quickly.
Yeah.
Like nowadays, obviously, 15 years old boy, as I said before, you have to watch out. Like, you know, and London is not an easy city anymore. It's a tough place to live. And when, you know, our kids are doing really well, mashallah. And we didn't get that kind of support because we had to support our family.
Yeah.
Now we don't need to support the family.
Now you know, the kids are getting pushed to study and they're given that freedom as well.
My children, they didn't even brought up in, I brought up in a council house, social house, and then, you know, we struggled for living in space. My brother used to share one room. But I never used to see my brother. He used to go to work morning, and then by the time he comes in, I used to go to sleep. Different time, yeah?
Yeah.
So, but my kid hasn't seen, like, those tough life, you know what I mean?
Well, that's because of your hard work, So, alhamdulillah, because of your hard work, you've achieved something that the children have got a very easy life. That's what it's all about, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's what it's all about. But, you know, just to mention something in the middle, you know, my Taloi, yeah? He was a very rich man in Bangladesh, but he sent his sons to, and I speak about him sometimes, he sent his sons to this country to work in a restaurant. The point is, work, feel the pain, feel the labor, okay? And then you'll have the love for the money. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Because as we know, there are a lot of places that the parents, they make a lot of money, and the children, they sort of spend it.
There's no shame.
So as long as you teach them.
Sorry, but there's no shame to earn money with working.
Yeah.
But there's a shame to earn money begging.
Absolutely.
I mean, like into ami kono kamra gilla kortam na because job is a job
yeah
you have to support your family khe khore restaurant khe khore cabin go khe khore you know everyone doing this you know and I involved with every sector like even in the catering I'm involved in a lot of things but ami kono job re kono small mono kore na even now ami jodi if I go to my restaurant and if they're busy I'll go and help if, whatever I know, you know what I mean? So that's what I do.
Okay.
And so going back to the clerks, obviously, I thought working in clerks and earning $2,000, $3,000 or whatever, selling cars, I'm not going to be what I want to achieve.
No. So, okay. So basically, you used to work in clerks first and then you went off to selling cars because clerks
I was selling cars in between clerks.
In between clerks, okay.
Yeah, but in between clerks, yeah. And basically...
So what's the reason for that? Is it because...
for make money. It wasn't about making money. It was about something you enjoy.
You enjoyed that.
Even now, like I buy properties, yeah? Mm. Even now, as we speak, I'm buying a property probably. But thing is, it's not about making money. It's just, you have to enjoy.
Like you're absolutely. Doing, you have to have the passion.
You are here doing this show. You know, you enjoy that as well.
Oh, yes.
Yeah? Without motivation, you can't, you know.
Definitely.
Yeah, so that's the thing. So,
definitely.
And that was the first thing I did. And I looked at other people and I see they become rich. And I always to follow up people. Okay. One thing about me, when I see people doing well, I feel very happy for them.
Yep.
But at the same time, I'm on the road. I want to be like this person one day.
Fantastic.
You know, as I said before, my role model was Nasir Bhai. If he's watching, I'm sure, you know, he used to sell cars. He used to sell cars.
So
I learned from him.
Fantastic.
And, you know, and I used to go with him to buy and sell cars.
I've got to stop you there. Very interesting. We're gonna go for a short break, and after that we'll continue about the car sales part of it. Okay, viewers. So we are gonna go for a short break, and we'll see you after the break. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum and welcome back. We had a short break. Those of you who have just joined us, we are with Sufi Bhai here. Sufi Bhai, he is a property tycoon, I should say, business entrepreneur, managing director of ATN Bangla. So we have been chatting for the last half an hour. We had a short break, but we're back now. And Sufi Bhai, so we were talking about the car sales business earlier on. So just elaborate on that a little bit and we'll move on to something else.
It wasn't a full-time job, car business. It was like part-time, shokha hortam, but because I still love cars. But when I first bought my car, I didn't even know how to drive.
Right.
So I got my brother to come and drive.
Really?
For me. Yeah.
And but you became a car salesman.
Car salesman. But
it was legal at that time to buy a car, and then as long as you have the trader's trade insurance and so forth.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I did that for a while, and then I thought, gari besa. You're going to make £1,000 a profit every car, or maybe £500, whatever, it's a small amount.
Yeah.
If I want to be a big, I need to do something big.
Absolutely.
So I've got a few friends.
Is that when you moved on to properties?
Yeah, so a few friends there that I go, I remember one of my friend was saying, oh, you know what, you have to pay council tax bill, guest bill. I mean, my And then I was put off by 6 months.
Mm.
And I thought, no, I need to go into this business.
Yeah.
And those days, property market was quite low, but it was also like picking up time.
Okay.
So the problem was, I mean, £1,000. Like, you know, I never used to give any money at home.
Yeah.
My dad never used to take any money from us. Yeah. And so, but I mean, waste khortam na fasha, right?
Which
doesn't mean that I mean khoras khortam na. Amar khoras khortam, amar wisely spend khortam.
Yeah.
And then my first property I bought in Archway.
Right.
And you know, and
so you're not selling cars anymore.
I'm still selling cars.
So you're still working in clerks.
Yeah.
Wow, look, just for the viewers, I mean, look how many things this gentleman is doing. You know, just to achieve and the position that the position that he's in. Without doubt, I mean, who wouldn't be? So let me just say, sorry, you were working in clerks, you're selling cars at the same time, and now you have moved into buying properties, or let's say the first property.
First property, yeah.
Fantastic.
So I bought that property, and then, you know, Jokhar Sirak, you know, taxi na raki foila gya, but
rent. But it wasn't to live,
it wasn't,
you wanted to,
And you know, and then I.
Let's not get to the nitty gritty of it because we know how people used to buy property that time.
Yeah.
But you know, just to get onto the ladder.
Yeah.
Just to get onto the ladder. You know, there's a few loopholes that you need to.
But you know, those days were buying property was easy.
Yeah.
But even now, people ask me, "Is Sufi Bhai, is it right time for us to buy property or kita?" But I always say, I always think like this: Amar abbai, ba afnar abbai, ba zera viewa goro ason thara abbai, da 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 di zera zagazomin kinchon.
Yeah.
I scammed a London takia.
Yeah.
Amra same zaga bishnat ba silet ba mole wazar kintam harmoni. Impossible.
It's impossible.
With that normal income.
I know.
Normal income. You go and buy mole wazar a basha.
Yeah.
You look in a
That's why if anybody says anything to me, I mean, well, whatever we have in Bangladesh, my dad did it. I haven't done it.
Nor has
my brother.
That's it.
So, we can't get it. It's right in the town. We can't get it. We're thinking of ourselves.
They used to send it back to Bangladesh.
Yeah.
Plus, they used to leave Khoshtokhori.
Yeah. Absolutely, yes.
So this is where my first property was. As soon as I bought that and the rental income was good, I'm going to go like a machine, yeah? Like you put your on the loot paper.
Money printing machine, is it? Or keep your room to let
or house to rent.
Yeah.
You used to get about 100 call. I'm not a man to get late. But we used to get fed up. You know, you can only pick up 10 phone calls, and out of 10, you're going to find a tenant. I know nowadays it's difficult.
So you were overwhelmed with phone calls.
And I remember I told my dad.
With the interest of
When I do something good, I get really excited. Yeah. Even now I do something, I mean, the excitement, which I need, right? I share my things, yeah? So I told my dad goes, he was in Bangladesh. He goes, man, he didn't believe me.
Yeah.
So when he came to London, so I said to him, look, ogoro to labor nini. So taina mar ki khila da baba mi, you know, I leave it to you because you know what you're doing.
Yeah.
And one of my property, I remember, I bought it in Wood Green, right? And I took my mom because she's my mom, I'm married to you, right? Like, is that a blessing for you?
Right.
I thought I was going to shun the lacto. You know, I'm afraid I got lore,
yeah? Yeah, yeah.
Like, I got off on the
road. I was not an easy thing. I was not a goal, he says, it's a big achievement.
Like, working in West End, it wasn't a small thing, it was a big thing.
So most people used to work in Indian restaurants.
That's it, yeah. So basically, so when I went to the house, I took my mom, and my father, Baba, Amarto, Gondo, after Kutar Gondo, like it smells of pets, yeah. So anyway, I went left and I bought the house for 53,000.
Wow.
Right? And 53 or 58,000, it looks like. It was just very cheap.
Can you just mention the year, please?
I can't remember, it's about quite a long time. But anyway, so what happened is, as soon as I refurbished the house, I got the agent back again, the agent I bought it from. Tara khoy go 80,000. I'm like, what they talking about 80,000, man? Ami hara bosor kham kori 20,000 dollar korte pari na. You know, this is something different. Then I look at you know, I'm the Bangladeshi community. We have successful people.
Yeah.
I don't want to mention their name because there's so many of them.
Yeah.
And they used to do property business. You know, and tara hishomo ta amra tara kotha mattam beshi, you know, jene inoro restaurant inoro kotha free holo ta. So tokhon, you know, like Kalambai is one of our older brother. Yeah. I used to look at them as well. Yeah. And then I thought, this is the right business. I think I can't work in retail because if you want to be successful, you have to have your own business, but you have to start from somewhere.
Absolutely, yeah? Yes.
So, and that's why I want
so
to
you So when you came into the property business, you saw the profit margin was very
profit
high
margins, yeah.
And you thought, well, this is it.
Look,
is that it?
You need a motivation, but always, you know, if you want to be an entrepreneur, you have to have something. The money has to come in. Without money,
Look,
I've got other business, but I'm as a business of course, I'm going to try.
You don't give that much time to it?
No, I'm going to say, because sometimes you can't chase and you can't keep trying.
Yeah,
if it's
yeah.
not working, it's not for you.
You can't chase something that is not really giving you any returns.
The property market is Sharibai is always going to be number one. Real estate is always real estate.
Absolutely, yes.
You're going to get wiped. Where at the moment is like going downwards, yeah? But, you know, London is London.
Mm.
Like, I go to Dubai. I just recently been in Singapore, Dubai.
Okay.
When I go holiday, people think I'm going holiday. I actually go for research.
Okay.
My kids' family have holiday.
Right.
But I still have research middle of the night.
Because that's your passion, you see.
Passion,
because you're business orientated.
Yeah.
You're business motivated, if you like. You're someone whose enjoyment is that.
You need to have, as I said before, you need to have your passion, you need to have a goal.
Well, that's why we have you here, and so people can learn from you. Everybody's not the same.
Sorry,
right?
Today, you invite me twice to come to your show, and I keep letting it down.
Yeah.
Today, I wasn't, you know, my son's got trial today, this evening, and I'm here because I want to give time, and at least I'm going to do the
Definitely.
And it's good.
Well,
your
intention is good, and thank you again for coming.
Yeah.
Okay, so now you're into the property business. Now, we know that, I mean, look, like you said, you got to the property business and you thought to yourself, okay, this is it, the profit margin is high and all that. But we know that's not entirely true because your passion is in other places as well, your interest in other places, it never stops.
And now we know
that you also got into the TV business, let's say.
How did
you get into that? What made you get into that?
Well, TV is not a business. TV, again, is a something to support the community.
Okay.
I remember my dad's love, our Prime Minister, Sheikh Hasina.
Okay.
Right? And he always used to watch ATN Bangla.
Okay.
I shouldn't be saying here, but you know, we are in TV One.
You already said it.
yeah, but you know, we have all the channels are good.
Yep.
But he used to watch mainly that channel.
Yeah.
And that's, there was a reason for our joining, because there was a problem with the TV, and I thought I can help Hafiz Bhai. And Hafiz Bhai is my CEO of the ATN Bangla.
Right, okay.
And he does really hard work. And
yep.
Any business, you need support. You need financial support.
Absolutely.
You need other staff, moral support as well.
Right, right.
Not always financial support, moral support.
No, absolutely. Yes, yes.
And I joined in the TV to support the community. Yeah.
Right, okay.
You know, my show I did is for, you know, to teach other people. Mm. You know, motivate the young generation.
Yeah.
You know, we need the young.
But we know about these TV channels. Like, you know, there's many TV channels. I'm not going to mention any names, but I think personally, it's doing the greater good. Okay.
Yeah.
So you know, it's definitely. For the community, it's definitely an inspiration. And we, you know, for example, charities and stuff like that, we can go through these TV channels. It's a platform.
It's
definitely, 100% helping the community, especially Bengali Muslim communities.
You're right. So, you're right in the platform. You said platform.
Yeah.
When I joined the TV, I had a lot of issues. Shall I join in or shall I not? It's not a cheap toy. It's a very expensive toy.
No, absolutely, yes.
So, the first thing I mean, we are blessing to Allah, we can go Bangladesh every week. Yeah,
okay.
Besides the, there is still family problem. You know,
in
our community, we still have so much problems. Yeah, so they still thinking Bangladesh 15 years ago, 20 years ago. Asil, Bangladesh has moved on. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
So, if they are watching my channel or TV One, if they can see Bangladeshis in the shakhol, then they relate to that. And that was the whole thing. And it's not all business is not about making money. And I say to look, in our community, you have a successful business people. But you have to have a passion, you have to have a good heart brought back to you.
Definitely.
And sometimes you have to give.
So we need people like you, Sufi Bhai. Yeah. We need people like you to be in these this market and create platforms like this. Why we need people like you? Like what you just mentioned now, a lot of people, for example, they're not able to see Bangladesh. You are actually giving them something in return.
Yeah.
You're giving them something very big in return.
Like, you know, you got TV One,
yeah,
and you have people watching Islamic program. When the Islamic program, I even watch.
Yeah, so
and then
people are learning.
We learn so much.
Definitely,
learning never stops.
Yeah.
I
mean, nowadays they can do courses on TV.
Yeah, I'll be honest with you. Islamic zinish shokol amra hikzi television taki dekhiya. Apne Bangladesh or Shadaran maula na kaise ki zinish
So no, definitely it's look the with regards to TV. I think, like I said, it's a massive, massive achievement in our community. And whoever's, you know, initiated it, you know, I take my hats off to them. So, and you're one of them, definitely.
Look, every TV owners are suffering.
Yeah.
They're working very, very hard to support, you know, to work with their community,
no,
to help the community.
I'm sure.
It's not, short business.
May Allah help you guys with the success of TV channels. And someone like you, again, what I was going to say is, you know, when you said that it's not all about making money. So when you reach a certain level, then you have to become a philanthropist, which any altruist, for example, helping human beings.
Yeah.
And I know TV One, for example, you know, people like Rezwan Bhai and stuff like that.
They
go to many, many places and they're helping so many, you know, underprivileged, these poor people, they have to walk miles and miles for water. So this is because of TV channels and Allah has given us a way. But anyway, going back.
It's not easy to someone sit down for charity show for 8-9 hours.
Hours and hours, yes.
Amra ekhon to boiya gorom lager ekta example dilam. Yeah, and they have to stand ruzamasho mata lage. You know, it's not easy. So,
Okay, so you've moved on to, so we got the properties and stuff like that. You moved on to, you bought yourself a TV channel.
Yeah, that was that, you know.
I said it very, what do you call, casually, as you can see. You bought yourself a TV channel.
Well,
you must be doing very good for yourself.
It was supporting the community.
And then I heard that, I was actually a part of it. You know, this sports part of the old everybody get together. What's your interest in sports then?
Well, I love football.
Sorry, that was a question that I just
I love football. I'm not very fan of cricket.
Right.
But I know we do all the media cup, we do like
all the
cricket
every
year.
And
we have been won last 2 years,
yeah.
You know. And ATN Bangladesh won, and they played really good.
Yeah.
So my biggest passion is about football, and I do go and watch. I mean, season ticket holder for Arsenal, and my son's play football, and he plays semi-pro football game. Okay. And you know, one day he might be a footballer, or he might not be. Yeah.
Can I take the liberty of asking? Do you have any plans of buying maybe a football club or something?
I said to my son, if you can't,
if you do something like that,
I wish I can. I wish I had that kind of money. But I said to my son, if you can't become a football player in the UK, I can buy you a team in Bangladesh. I'm sure I can arrange something. Yeah.
In Bangladesh.
But the thing is, football is it's a sport, but.
You've achieved so much, Sufi Bhai. You've achieved so much. You know, don't underestimate yourself. Yeah. But anyway, go on.
Thank you. But you know, any kind of sport is good for the young people. We can stay away from lots of bad stuff. Yeah. So you know, Jahori. Mm. But you know, the property is the best way to move.
You say property is the best way to move forward. Bricks and mortars, real estate, or semantics I'm using here, all the same word. But it's something that has given you a boost. And you have been able and afford to move on to different things. Okay, well, we've got to get a few other things in. So sports, one of the things, maybe one day, maybe who knows?
Yeah.
Who knows? Maybe one day you can buy a team.
Well, or
maybe a small football club. You know this particular cricket tournament that has taken place? It's called the T10 Media, and I'm sure I can, not a problem mentioning it, because I remember last year I was personally in the meetings and stuff like this. Something getting bigger, so I would ask you to be more involved in it.
I was involved last year. And basically this year I was a why.
Yeah. Well,
and
your channel has won twice, it's a great achievement.
Look, any kind of sports, we should support them, because when you become after 40, you need more exercise, more healthy.
And physically it helps us.
Of course,
it's getting the community together as well.
The T10 cricket, I mean, support even though I don't get involved, behind the scene, I'm not involved. But I think it's a teamwork. Every TV channel or every business people has to have a teamwork.
Yeah, absolutely.
And, you know, and sometimes your staff doesn't come and talk to you when you're in the pitch. Mm. So they become normal to you, like same level.
And organizing such a thing is not easy as well. So, you
know, thank you to Kennedy Roof, you know, for helping.
Definitely. All these brothers who have, you know, worked so hard. Yeah. To get
Bubble Buy also works really hard on AT in Bangladesh, you know?
And you're part of it. Like, and you're part of it. Now, going back to business again, there's one thing I wanted to ask you is, you know, a lot of us have done business, and we also have some businesses we can't do it without partners. Some businesses we do it ourselves. You know, how have you, give us some advice with regards to partners in business. Has it been good? Has it been bad? You know, I'm sure you've had partners and stuff like that.
Can you clarify that?
Okay, so. Business, sometimes we go forward in business by ourselves, sole traders and so forth, okay? But sometimes we need to have partners in it. Do you understand? Maybe because the know-how of the business is not so much from our own selves, so we need to get someone who knows about the business. So what I'm asking you is to give us some advice.
To be partnership.
On partners. And if you have had partners, would you say that it has been a successful partnership? Sometimes partners, they have problems between each other and stuff like that. Well, so, you know, sometimes people sell businesses because of partners.
Sorry, but, you know, I'm I can't really give advice of that because I'm myself a victim,
Oh, you're a victim?
I'm a victim of that, And, you know, sometimes you become gullible and you do a lot of things in life and you trust people.
Okay.
So my advice is, like, anybody wants to do business, do it properly.
Okay.
Do it properly.
Choose the right partners. But sometimes you wouldn't know the right partner.
Doesn't matter about right partner, but you've got to have a paperwork right. Do it properly.
Okay. So no one can actually...
Look, we always do on trust. Mm. Like we say Muslim brother, this, that. But business is business. Yeah. In business...
Business is business.
There's no trust on the business. Okay. And my advice is, like, anyone watching this show tonight, you know, and basically, you know, they want to be partnership. I'll say to them, especially now a restaurant owner, partner, a problem. But partnership to gato mancho greed. A is become greed, and B when the business doesn't do well.
Yeah.
That's why you have problem. Yeah.
Right.
So you know.
Your advice is negative of the experience that you had.
If you can do yourself, it's best. But sometimes you can initiate some partner lage.
Yeah, yeah.
But my advice is going to be do it properly.
Okay.
You know, get a lawyer, do it properly. Tomorrow, do that proper way.
Okay, thank you. Quickly on personal issues now. You're a very busy man, we know that. How do you cope with family, children and stuff like that? Quickly, just tell us in 1 minute so we can move into something else.
Basically, I do spend a lot of time with my family. I give a lot of time with my children. Because I take in 3-4 days. A lot of my community people say, Sufi, I have not done anything. But I'm in the community. I mean, I'm working with everyone, but at the same time, I give a lot of time to my family. And I think it's important for us, for you as well, the age of our children now, we have to, they are our future.
Yeah, so you invest in them.
Investing, right. Investing our time on them. And you know, and
so you mentioned earlier on what you said is you take your family to holiday, but you are doing your research. So you kill two birds with the same stone.
Yeah, I'm always doing research. I recently been to Dubai and I'm done research on property. Yeah. And probably be your viewers will be interested. You know, Dubai is a crisis.
That's something I got to think about actually. Yeah, kill two birds with the same stone. It's fantastic, yeah, isn't
Dubai
it?
Dubai is a crisis place, but where is a crisis, it's always money to make.
You know, the demand is there.
Demand
right?
is there. Yeah. Like I don't know about demand, but you always got money to make. Even in UK, we're having a problem with the Brexit now. Yeah.
Yeah.
So basically, we're talking about Kito Igbo, but I'm telling you, it's nothing going to happen. I've been in this property business for many years. Sure. Right? But the one thing is, it's a safe. If you're going to buy a house today,
yeah,
and you want to make money tomorrow, then don't buy a house now. Like, it's uncertain. Yeah.
But say that again, say that again.
If you're going to buy a property today to make money tomorrow,
yeah,
then my advice is don't buy it, right? Because you don't know what's happening tomorrow. But if you're buying for rental income,
all right, okay,
right? If you're buying for long-term, property is a long-term investment.
So now you cleared it, okay. Because you buy something to make money tomorrow, don't you? So yeah, you're saying not to do it.
But no, I'm saying, but you have to know the right property.
Mm.
You can buy a property today and you can make 100,000 tomorrow if you want to, but you have to know the right thing. But most average people buy property for long term.
Okay. You know, so thank you. Well, you know what? As you know, some of the questions you've actually answered in terms of you know, what types of problems you faced. You talked about partnership and stuff like that. Any other types of problems that you face? Something that we should be aware of?
No, in business, maybe
a quick advice.
There's no advice. I think any business you do little research. I have asked by someone, Sufiba, how do you do this? How do you do that?
Mm.
But you have to have a team.
Okay.
If your team is good, well, you have to keep an eye on your team.
You've got to have a good team behind
you. Yeah, good team on behind you.
What are the tips you're going to give us about, in terms of business, you know, just give us three tips. That's what I normally ask, my guests.
You have to have a dream. That's important.
Okay,
like, you
dream.
Have to have your finances, obviously, must be.
Okay.
Without finance, you can't have a dream.
So you have to have backup capital, right? Yeah, so that should be.
Sometimes
strong.
You become partner with slightly. You know what, I will say, if someone wants to become a partner with someone's got more money,
yeah,
and they can work and they can support that,
okay,
that's also good for them because that's their backup.
Yeah? All right, okay.
But whenever you do any business by yourself, if you are determined to win, I'm sure it will work, you know.
Okay. We got capital, finance, yeah, and stuff like that. Honesty?
Honesty is a very important thing, you know, like, you know, in life, people can change. So
yeah,
honesty is very important, surely, by not only hereafter
let
as
money
well.
Not make
you
change.
Yeah, yeah.
So we got two here. One more. You got to give us one more. Capital, you said.
Yeah.
Honesty is the second one. I don't think you gave us one.
What's the one? Usually I ask people questions. It's like you need to be positive. You need to be focused on what you want.
Determined. Positive,
you need
determined,
to be hungry. You know,
committed.
Like I buy houses now not because to make money.
No.
I buy houses because I enjoy it.
You enjoy it.
And you know that.
Well, you know, so, what better than enjoying making
blessing,
money? What better than that?
I'm blessing with my brothers as well. That we
Mashallah.
All brothers, you know, stick together.
Okay.
We help each other.
So maybe that's another thing. If you've got a family,
United is very important,
yeah,
especially our Bangladeshi community.
Families.
We're very blessing. I'm not sure United Tech as well as help Kori. You know.
Okay, mashallah. Okay. Well, any future plans for yourself at the moment?
I've got no future plans, Sharif, but I just want to look after my family and, you know, to, you know, do well in life, you know, and dua kor barak jara dekhra, you know, johri dene Allah amdare bala rakhta, you know, health, everything, you know, that's the most important thing.
I say, mashallah. Well, listen, I'm, you know, once again, I would like to thank you hugely for coming onto the show. And I know how it has been a difficult, you know, task for myself.
Oh my gosh,
but you know, thank you, and TV1 wants to thank you as well for coming onto the show. You've given us, you know, a lot of advices, and I'm sure we've learned a lot from that. You know, you are definitely an inspiration to the community. People do talk about you in a very, very positive way. And I hope that youngsters can see your achievement. And now that you're mentioning Dubai, Singapore, places like that, you know, me personally, that's my dream. My dream would be to be able to make money while I'm traveling. while I'm traveling the world. Look, do you understand?
That world is so small now.
Yeah.
It's in your phone.
It is.
It's in your phone, yeah? So, yes. Thank you again, Shelly, by inviting me. And thank you to the TV One and the staff working behind the scene.
Yep.
These are the people making us sitting here. So thank you very much. And the viewer who's watching us tonight, I'm sure it's a benefit to them as well.
Yep.
And thank you for inviting me again. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, back to the viewers. Well, thank you for watching. Sufi Bhai here, because he's a very important person in the community. But you've heard what he had to say, and hope we can benefit from him. Until next time, I'm Sharif Islam, and we'll see you again with another successful businessman. Thank you very much, and assalamu alaikum.